Good evening and welcome. You're watching Trending Tonight with me, Sanket Upadhyay. Two stories that we are going to discuss right here. Story number one, all is not well in Uttar Pradesh. You will have to believe the series and the manner in which these meetings are taking place to realize that this is a big headache for the Bharatiya Janata Party central leadership. There seems to be a huge disconnect between the government as well as the party, and that is why these feedback meetings are taking place to review ahead of the elections. What do they mean and how are they going to play out in terms of this gentleman that you see on your screen right now? Will he be spearheading the Bharatiya Janata Party into the February 2022 elections? All that and much more in just a short moment. Also on the show, class 12th board examinations have been cancelled. These board exams have been cancelled, but there is suspense, massive suspense over the assessment process. You see, the exam has been cancelled, but the result will still come out because a lot is dependent on this result. So how is this result going to be calculated? And also certain other questions. We are going to discuss this with students because they know best about their career. All right, so story number one, what's happening in Uttar Pradesh? So there is a performance review of the Yogi government where a two-day review meeting is taking place in Uttar Pradesh. Top leaders are reviewing the performance just months before the elections. Remember, elections in February 2022. This meeting was chaired by top party leaders from Delhi, including the General Secretary Organization, Mr. B.L. Santosh. As of now, the information that we are getting is that there is no plan to replace the Chief Minister, Yogi Adityanath. How did it become this bad? Because of the COVID response in the state, which has come under sharp criticism, and also panchayat election results, which have not been much to write home about for the Bharatiya Janata Party. Leaders have met Chief Minister Adityanath as well as his deputies. These meetings are happening in special circumstances and thus raising a lot of speculation. So what is this feedback drive? Let me quickly tell you. Party General Secretary B.L. Santosh has met leaders. This is an attempt to take feedback from the leadership. Separate meeting with party functionaries. There is an obvious attempt to course correct just ahead of polls. Indications are also there of a structural change in the government as well as the party. And this was initiated, this indication came when a meeting took place between the RSS and the BJP. Remember, and Yogi Adityanath was not part of this meeting. This happened last week. Months to go for the polls, and obviously all is not well when the central BJP leaders are scrambling to save Fortress Uttar Pradesh. It got them 300 plus in 2017. They want to repeat their tally. At least that's what is the expectation of the Deputy Chief Minister, Keshav Prasad Maurya.
बहुत अच्छी चर्चा हुई है 2022 में हम लोग फिर एक ऐतिहासिक विजय प्राप्त करेंगे
बताया जा रहा कि सर 2022 है या कुछ और भी है क्योंकि बहुत कम चर्चा है
2022 300 पार
All right, so you heard Mr. Maurya there saying that 2022 mein 300 par, which means that in 2022, BJP will cross 300 yet again. Juhi Singh, spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, is with us. In just a short moment, we'll have Dr. Sarjeet Singh Dang, former minister in the UP government and a BJP leader. Ms. Singh, thank you very much. I want to ask you, what would you make of this confidence of Mr. Keshav Prasad Maurya, who seems to say that the BJP will cross 300?
See, the BJP is an institution which is thriving on spreading mismanagement, institutional manipulation of people. So this is their work, the appraisal which they have to take of Yogi Adityanath, because he symbolizes everything which BJP stands for. And also the COVID mismanagement, which has caused deaths in UP due to lack of oxygen. There's the vaccination strategy completely gone haywire. So accountability, corruption charges are coming up in Kasturba Gandhi Vidyalayas, also in the handling of the corona, oxygen cylinders, medicines. Maybe they need to do this stock taking internally, or maybe they need to distract the people from these issues, because people of UP are hurt. They've been let down. down by the chief minister, who as a hobby campaigns. I mean, he's very busy campaigning, and the only thing he symbolizes is trying to portray that he is very decisive with phrases like thok do, which he uses according to his own convenience, you know, slapping various cases on people who speak, who write stories, or who maybe, you know, belong to rural hinterlands. They cannot take action against him, and really accommodating larger issues or ignoring them. I mean, his own social media setup has had a
serious problem. Where do you think is the problem? I mean, if you speak to the BJP leaders, they would say that there is no problem whatsoever.
That's really up to them, because what can they say? See, this is a party which doesn't believe in working. That is not their ethics. They only believe in, they are the party based on pracharaks. So publicity is in their very genetic, I would say, DNA. So maybe it's not coming down well on the people. And the first time people of UP are not going to be emotionally manipulated. We've all seen our near and dear ones dying. We've been literally running for beds, oxygen, medicines. And we've had a chief minister who has largely been very insensitive. So it's really up to, it's really, I think, attention distracting from the issue behavior. And I thought that these people had these regular internal appraisers. It was a very modern, digitally oriented party. And what about their own MLAs? I mean, are they meeting them? Because that's where I think the dissatisfaction was, because the chief minister was not really listening to them. So whether they want to establish Yogi Adityanath, or whether they want to really give a sort of a legitimacy that fine, there is an institution other than the UP government which can really take into account the difficulties the people of UP have passed. It's really up to them, but the people of UP are not going to be distracted. I mean, we have had...
Okay. Sure. Dr. Sarjeet Singh Dang is also with us, former minister of the UP government. Dr. Dang, I want to ask you, you know, obviously, this is a moment where the Samajwadi Party is going to rub their hands in glee. But the point is, can you hear me? Can you hear me, sir?
Hello.
Dr. Surjeet, can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm there.
Okay. Dr. Surjeet, I want to ask you, what is happening in your party right now? The manner in which these abnormal meetings are taking place, how do you explain them?
In democracy, I don't think any meeting is abnormal. What is abnormal?
I'll tell you what is abnormal. For the General Secretary organization to hold meetings for this long, for there to be a review meeting, for the RSS to hold meetings in which the Chief Minister himself is not there, allegations that the Chief Minister did not take phone calls from the Prime Minister's office. I mean, all of this, I should not be telling you this, I'm sure. You are in Uttar Pradesh, you know all this and much more.
Most of these, whatever you can call it, are rumors. And everybody is making a guess what is going on. I'm very sorry to say, there is a particular section of the press, whether electronic or print. They always see, you know, like a crow. People say, a crow is a one-eyed bird. So they see only by, they use their one eye only.
No,
all the negative
come
ones.
On.
All the
negative don't be so unkind. Dr. Sarjeet.
They only see it. They don't see the other side of the coin.
What is the other side? Okay, if I were to ask Dr. Sarjeet, tell me the other side.
I'll explain to you what
is the BJP, you know, coming out smelling of roses in this crisis.
I tell you what is the other side. See, a section of the press, I mean, including the international press, which is supposed to be an honest press, they took this issue of the dead bodies, you know, in the Ganges. And when everything was clear that this is a part of the you know, ceremonies in certain sections of Hinduism, even Mohammedans. So now they are exposed. The other part is the Yogi model in UP has succeeded like anything.
How?
WHO has appreciated it. The death rate is minimum here, keeping in view the population of this great state. The number of infected patients is very less.
Dr. Sarjeet, can I ask you a question?
particular section of the press.
I just want to ask you.
Whether printed or electronic.
Okay, Dr. Sarjeet, it's surprising that you feel that all that is ailing Uttar Pradesh is the national and international media.
Look at the negative side.
No, one moment.
People should learn. The journalism should learn that they should see both the sides of the coin.
Yeah, sure, absolutely.
Both their eyes.
Journalism should be fair. Journalism should also be fair enough to see that there was an unusually high number of floating dead bodies and bodies being thrown off the bridge from ambulances.
And what is the conclusion? How they concluded it? Because so many people are dying, so many, the deaths are being hidden. And when
Dr. Sarjeet, when you juxtapose official figures with the shallow graves, there was obviously a mismatch.
Exposed. There are certain sections in the media.
Dr. Sarjeet, I find it surprising.
Negative narratives.
Dr. Dang, I'm finding it surprising that you feel that the only thing that ails Uttar Pradesh is the media, particularly international media. I want to ask you this question. How will you explain the fact that there are BJP's own MPs, four of them to be precise, many ministers in the Yogi cabinet, all writing letters to highlight that there was shortage, that there was mismanagement?
I don't know how many of those letters are really, really genuine.
You will doubt your own MPs.
No, it is again a conjecture.
Dr. Sarjeet, are you doubting letters written by your own ministers? Brajesh Pathak wrote a letter. The Mohanlal Ganj MP has written a letter. The Meerut MP has written a letter.
Might have written. I think if it is he has written, it is not a bad thing. If there is some weakness there, if there is something wrong, see, as a public representative, he has all the rights to write it, inform, intimate the higher authorities, in the party and in bureaucracy, to draw their attention so that the things can be corrected.
Sure.
What is wrong there?
Dr. Sarjeet,
that shows that there is immense...
I will just ask you this final
dialogue
question.
Dialogue in BJP.
Dr. Sarjeet, there is definitely conversation that the government and the party seem divorced and delinked in Uttar Pradesh. That's the criticism. Do you think going forward in February 2022, the leadership is going to remain? You will fight the next elections under the leadership of Yogi Adityanath?
Sure.
Okay. We'll leave it at that and we'll see what happens as far as the BJP's UP unit is concerned.
It has dealt with the problems. It has been appreciated by WHO, which is a neutral body.
Well,
and still people are not, they are not prepared to see the light of the day.
I think it should be in your interest to see criticism how it is.
Our objective is to be fair and neutral.
And I think we've done a commendable job being neutral as far as reporting out of Uttar Pradesh is concerned.
Nindak nere rakhiye aangan kuti chhawaye.
Absolutely.
In sabun pani bina chit nirmal ho
jaye. And isn't this exactly what many leaders of the Bharatiya Janata Party are trying to tell Yogi Adityanath? Nindak nere rakhiye. Keep your critics close.
Whether central or UP government.
Okay. Dr. Sarjeet as well as Juhi Singh, thank you very much. I've completely run out of time. Let's quickly move on to our discussion number two. What will happen in Uttar Pradesh, we'll know. February is not far away, but the point is all is not well in UP politically. All right, our second topic of discussion is the big decision that has been taken by the Modi government, a very welcome decision to cancel the 12th class board exams, ending the pain and agony of lakhs of students. It's going to benefit a lot of students. ICSC has also cancelled its class 12th examinations. But, there is suspense over the assessment. How is this assessment going to be carried out? Because the results are still going to come out. And there are three important questions that we want to put on screen right now. The big questions. Big question number one is, what will be the criteria for assessment? The point that we were making just a short while ago. Big question number two, how will we ensure parity between CBSE and state board results? Now, this is a huge issue of concern. Chhattisgarh has already started open book exams. There are other states who are also taking this exam. But then CBSE has cancelled it. Do you see that there is a disparity? How do you do this? And number three, will there be clarity on how students will appear for competitive exams and what the modalities for that are going to be? Let me quickly introduce all our guests this evening, all students, because they know best about their career and their future. Tanushree Rai, Ritika Tiwari, Vaishnavi Srinivas Kotni, and Kashish Rizvi. Thank you very much, all of you all, for joining us. Kashish, I want to come with you. Come to you first. What do you think of this decision?
Sir, ठीक है बिकॉज कैंसिल बोर्ड एग्जाम करना बिकॉज इतने सारे लोग की पिटीशन जा रही थी पेरेंट्स भी स्टूडेंट्स भी एंड अदर पर्सनालिटीज भी बिकॉज ये सिचुएशन नहीं थी एग्जाम्स कंडक्ट करने तो आई थिंक मेरा रिव्यू तो यही है कि अच्छा किया मतलब
ओके ओके वैष्णवी आई वांट टू कम टू यू नाउ व्हाट डू यू थिंक ऑफ दिस दिस डिसीजन दैट हैज बीन टेकन
I'm definitely happy. It's been long due. It's been much awaited. We've been looking forward to the exams being cancelled because we've been in this sort of limbo where we did not know where we stand, whether the exams will happen or not. But it's also very overwhelming given that a year and a half of being in the same grade has just been over on a random Tuesday evening. But it's just half the battle won. We still have to decide. We still need to know how we will be graded. Finally, so that's the other part of the battle that the CBSE needs to inform us on.
Let me ask you, what do you think? How should you be graded?
Well, while I was reading the news, I saw that quite a few options were given. I don't know if that's final or not, or if it's...
I want to ask you, what do you think is the best way, given these circumstances, right. Now that the exams have been cancelled, what do you think could be the best possible way to carry out this assessment?
I think the best possible way would be to take a cumulative marking system from class 9 to 11 and also taking internal marks of class 12, given that we have been following the same sort of system of examination, of textbook learning and then giving the examination. I think that it'll be a fair system, but I also feel that it's a suggestion from my side that whatever formula the CBSE comes up with must be tested on previous batches to see whether this cumulative system is anywhere close to their class 12 marks. And if the system is actually feasible, because sometimes what can happen is if they do take this method, but it might not be fair. It might give some students an unfair advantage because they might have done well in school in the past years. So it needs to be tested properly.
Okay. Tanushree Rai as well as Ritika Tiwari are also with us. Tanushree, I want to come to you now. Now, obviously, one major concern is that, fine, thank you very much. You've cancelled the exams, ended the agony. But how is the assessment process going to go on? The other important point is that how do you ensure parity between state board students as well as CBSE students? Because in many states, students are taking their exams, they're writing exams.
So I think this is not fair with them state board students, because as we are CBSE and IAS students, we can feel them, because what anxiety, depression we are feeling now, same feeling is with them too also. Even you can see state boards are a little bit tough for them, because there's a lot of subjects and they have to go for the centers, as in the West Bengal, it was going on July, the exams was conducting on July. So I think there should be cancellation for them also, because we are the students and we want, like, we all were united and they're also helping us. So we want the cancellation. Even Modi ji has also told that jaan hai to jaan hai. So Modi ji hai to mumkin hai. So he can do about them also, state board students.
I'll just tell you how the federal structure works. The thing is that actually he cannot, apart from appealing to the state governments, he can't do much, because in a federal structure, Tanushree, what happens is that since education is the responsibility of the state, so respective state governments have to decide what they are going to do with the board examinations. That decision the central government can't take.
But sir, if our Prime Minister Modi appeal Chief Ministers,
sure,
and
sure,
the
that,
Education
and that,
Minister,
that apparently he has done. That apparently, yeah. In the press note that came today, he has already appealed to the various state governments to take a similar decision. Ritika Tiwari, you know, just taking off from where Tanushree left, see, the point is there will be disparity, right? There will be some state board which will have an unfair advantage or will be at a disadvantage. And then there will be a huge problem on how they get admission in universities, because you will not have parity as far as the marking system is concerned. Do you think that there should have, at the very least, been an effort where all of these political stakeholders and leaders should have sat together on a table and basically decided, bolted the door and would have told themselves that either we walk with one decision or we don't go out with any decision. One decision which will suit all students. Otherwise, there'll be this disparity.
Yeah, I absolutely agree, because the pandemic is the same for everyone. It's not different for CBSE students or state board students. I think all the chief ministers and our honorable and our prime minister should have come up together with a uniform policy for all the students, because the mental stress, the trauma is the same for every student here. It's not just about CBSE or state board. It's the same for everyone. So I think they should have definitely made a uniform policy for everyone, and they should have just come, because keeping politics aside, they all should have come together and made a uniform policy for all the students, keeping in mind the state boards, CBSE, ICSE or whatever.
Any questions that come to your mind, Ritika? There are three questions that we were able to collate after speaking to students. One is, of course, the criteria of assessment. What is the CBSE going to decide on the basis of, as far as the result is concerned? And secondly, how will you ensure parity, which we are discussing? Third is, will there be clarity on how students will appear for competitive exams? Would you want to add to this list anything else that is crossing your mind?
Yeah, see, there are some questions going on in my mind, and the one question is, like, according to some sources, they are saying that they will be taking the marks of 12th, 11th and 10th. So I just have one question, that many students leave their 10th standard, after giving the 10th standard board exams, they change their schools. So will there not be a communication gap or something like that? So there has to be communication between the schools and the authorities to ensure that the marking scheme is the same and fair for everyone. And I think this will be a challenge, I guess. But, you know, unusual times require unusual measures. So let's hope for the best.
Okay. Kashish, you know, this point that Ritika has made in an earlier broadcast also, she said that if you carry out this assessment, right, what will be the assessment period? Because exams have not happened. You have to grade students. Right now, I think someone mentioned that you should have the assessment period from 9th grade till 11th grade. But I think this very important point that Ritika made, that there are many students who change their schools after 10th grade. They go to do their 11th and 12th in some other school. So there will be a huge problem, logistical. It will be nightmarish to get these certificates, to put all these processes in place. What do you think?
Yes, sir. Of course, there will be a communication gap, and there will be problem arising about... sir, I think in, giving the student the grade on the behalf of their previous years, result, I don't think this is
Achha faisla nahi hai, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, let me see. Let's quickly circle back to a few of the other people who are speaking here. Maybe I can ask Tanushree this. Tanushree, what is your opinion on grading students on the basis of their past performance?
Sir, I think there should be options for the students. They can grade from their internal assessment, from 9 to 10, 11, their marks. And even, one more thing I have to add, there are some of the schools, they used to go for a favoritism. If the teacher, if the student is a favorite of teachers, that student will get a good marks, and other student will be like, if he or she is not liking that student, then of course the marks will be will be less. So there should be a good opinion for these students. Like, they should think something vast, that every student should be satisfied with that marks, because marks is a thing where we have to show in CV, in our like interviews, even our college interviews also asked our class 12 marks. Correct. As I have given.
Correct. Vaishnavi, I want to come back to you. You know, there is also a proposal, and I must tell you also that you are informed. There is also a proposal that the CBSE is considering that in case some student is not happy with the assessment, whatever the criteria may be, then that student as a last resort may also have this option available to sit for an exam whenever there is, you know, less number of corona cases and the time is conducive. Do you think that will be a good proposal?
While I do believe that every student must get an opportunity to improve their exams if they wish to, I don't know how that will be helpful considering that college admissions take place a lot before that. The CBSE is saying that whenever it's feasible, whenever they can hold the exams, they will. But what about these students who want college admissions in probably DU or other national universities where 12th marks are considered? What marks will they present to those universities? But I also think that the CBSE can look at it as an opportunity to make the college admissions process more holistic, considering that our potential has always been reduced to our marks for college admissions. Because of the cutoffs and because of how only class 12 marks matter.
I think that's very, very interesting. Let this not be an exception in testing times, but let it become the norm where you create a new system of assessment, which we
absolutely
need. I wish I were this young, that in my time there would have been a gradation like this. It would have saved me the nightmares. Thank you very much to all of you all for joining us. Stopping for a short break at this moment. News continues on the other side.